Greetings to you all. When we talk about achieving reference sound in a stereo listening room or home cinema, the discussion quite often revolves around hi-fi or high-end brands. While many of these products deliver excellent results, some are based on questionable scientific claims or place more emphasis on design than on true acoustic performance. But you don't have to focus only on hi-fi or high-end, there is another path you might want to explore – studio monitors. Built for professionals and used daily to produce the music and films we all enjoy, these speakers are designed for accuracy. While the only way to hear content exactly as mixing engineer intended is to be in the same room where it was created, using studio monitors at home can bring you much closer to that original sound than most consumer audio systems ever will. At GearFest in London, I had a chance to listen to Alcons Audio's MR10 studio monitors, and the experience only reinforced this understanding. The sound was so remarkable that I asked Tom Beck, co-founder and managing director of Alcons Audio, to join me for a spontaneous interview and share more with the audience of the BoardTech channel. Before we dive in into the world of Pro Ribbon technology, I have one small request. Please consider subscribing, giving this video a like, leaving a comment, or hitting the notification bell. All of this helps the channel reach a wider audience and allow me to keep making content like this. And if you would like to support BoardTech channel directly, you can use this Super Thanks feature here on YouTube, or consider becoming a patron on Patreon. All the links you need are in the video description below. Today we're here in London at the GearFest show. It's a one-day show about studio equipment. It's new to us, although this is the third time that we're exhibiting here at GearFest. We are here right now presenting the latest iteration of products that are soon to be released in the recording studio market. We've always had a presence from the cinema market product range. We've always had a presence in post-production studios. But that elevated and accelerated actually when Immersive Surround entered the studio market. Following that presence in post-production studios worldwide, we got a request for smaller systems, for near-field applications, and still have Immersive Surround processing. 2 years ago, we started developing a product for this market, and we started from scratch, but we said we still want to utilize the products and the technologies that we feature in our professional sound systems. We are a professional sound system manufacturer, so our designs are used in sound reinforcement, in larger touring applications, smaller performing arts theaters, although we're also present at Broadway, for instance, West End here in London. And House of Worship is a big market for us. Professional cinema is sort of different from most of the other manufacturers, as well as studio. And the approach we take with this development of these products is that we want to utilize the exact same technology we offer in creating something unique in studio, and then replicate the exact same development, the exact same creative process, regardless of audience size, application, or source material, and then maintain the exact same reference. And we've managed to do that. So the physical proof is actually here. It's a range of products. It's not only one speaker, but it's a number of speakers to be able to create a full immersive system configuration. And that's what we're presenting here at GearFest. While most speaker manufacturers rely on familiar technologies like soft dome tweeters, compression drivers, or even exotic materials such as beryllium or diamond, Alcons Audio stands out with something very different. Let's hear from Tom on what makes it so unique.
The Pro Ribbon technology, let's say the most eye-catching and the most ear-catching part of our technologies and our philosophy. But I have to say, it's just one part of it. If you would utilize this in any other manufacturer's system, it still wouldn't sound like an Alcons system, because it's all in the details, and not only in the actual transducer for the mid-high frequencies, it's also in the transducers for the mid and the low frequencies, and the processing and the amplification. So it's a whole chain of things that create the typical ultra-low distortion signature sound of Alcons Audio. However, having this technology, we wanted to see if we could utilize that in near-field applications, and also in that particular market raise the benchmark of what is possible in sound quality. the proof is in here with MR10, MR5. We utilize our RBN202 driver. It's a 2-inch driver from what we call the 02 platform. This is a very powerful driver. We don't use the power, the actual SPL output, but we use it for the headroom. So there's a very high dynamic headroom capability. Some advantages of the technology: it crosses over at 1 kHz. So in studio monitoring, the larger part of the vocal range is covered by only one transducer. Secondary, because of the fast impulse response, the lightweight moving mass of the driver, you have a very clear and accurate reproduction of the initial response as well as the reverb, that's what we call the tail of the reverb or the sustain. Also things like imaging and placement and positioning within the stereo imaging. It's all due to the high resolution capabilities of the Pro Ribbon driver. And of course, high SPL capability plus high sensitivity, because it's not only the power handling, but it's also the sensitivity they create that we have such enormous headroom that we also have an ultra low noise floor.
I've heard Alcons sound system at ISC 2025 in Barcelona and here at Gearfest in London, and every time the clarity really stand out. So when I learned that a few commercial cinemas in the Netherlands are using their speakers, I knew I had to visit them and feature the experience on my channel. So stay tuned.
So as I said, we demonstrate here, we have an immersive setup, but we demonstrate stereo as well. However, for this particular application, over the last 2 years, we got requests, people say the resolution is stunning, but I would love to hear it in an immersive, in this case, Dolby Atmos configuration. So we brought out a 7.1.4 configuration, which means we got MR10, we got left, center, right. This is the latest iteration, the latest model version of this. MR10 has been on the show for 2 years. A lot of things have happened in the meantime. For those in the know, we don't have a left, center, right dedicated model anymore. It's just now one symmetrical acoustical layout. Also, we changed the low frequency driving section. We were not satisfied still with the performance, and we couldn't replicate the unique signature sound of the MR5, the ultra compact monitor, into the bigger system. And now we have, it's a three-way system. It's got the Pro Ribbon driver on top from 1 kHz to beyond 20,000 Hz covered by one driver. It's non-compressed. As I said, it's linear. So that means that even at the lowest levels, medium levels, high levels, you got the exact same tonal balance. Operating gain window within, you have the same tonal balance, is much larger than with other systems. So it doesn't really matter how loud you play or how low you play, you still got the reference. As I said, also we have an RMS to peak power handling with the driver technology of 1:15. So instead of 1:2, so 50 watts RMS in this case is not 100 watt peak, but 50 watts RMS is 800 watt peak. So that's a massive difference in terms of dynamic behavior, particularly in studio monitoring, where you do not want any compression, any limiting, any change in tonal balance shift. That's ideal. Secondary, from 1 kHz down to about 250 hertz is taken care of by the 5-inch. This is unique in the sense that this is a 2-coil motor structure. It's one active coil connected to the cone, obviously, and then there's a secondary coil passive in the gap that takes away the inductance that's generated by the movement of the speaker. Any speaker, by moving, creates inductance, and the inductance comes back in the form of distortion and coloring. And with that setup motor structure, we take away the distortion and the coloring. So it's a supernatural response, and it is an ideal combination with RBN202 driver. And then below that, now for this year, this is new. This is the final configuration of the MR10. This is the way we're going to go into the market with this. It's a 3-inch coil, also has the secondary coil motor structure, what we call active coil, and again there you take away the coloration on the low mids. It's a super natural one-on-one reproduction, and as such, with all the three components, gives you the most natural ultra low distortion response possible. 10-inch connected to what we call the scoop vent. The scoop vent is actually an approach we had where normal bass reflex vents give you the problem of chuffing, so port compression, particularly at low frequencies but high port speeds, you get port compression, which again is a form of distortion. Some brands focus on a transmission line. The problem we have with transmission line is that we want to aim for the highest transient response possible, so we want a super accurate direct drive response also on the low frequency. So we opted for a direct drive venting construction, although the capacity, the breathing capacity is super high, so there's no port chuffing, there's no port compression happening. It's all in a package where the mid-high section can be rotated, speaker can be placed on its side. You can see we have absorbers in the baffle to take away the reflection from the baffle, high frequency reflection from the baffle, to increase the imaging. One of the responses we get on this system is that the imaging is not comparable to anything else on the market. And there's also a nice feature that the waveguide is what we call the hemp horn. So instead of using a glass fiber, which is highly resonant, we use a reinforcement, which is like a wood fiber. That's of course hemp. And of course, coming from the Netherlands, we said, let's use, in a circular economy, you need to utilize all the materials you have. So this is unique, also signature of our M-series range.
Most studio monitors on the market come with a built-in amplifiers, but Alcons Audio has taken a different path. One that not only shapes their signature sound, but also offers customers a bit more flexibility.
We have an ecosystem approach. I mean, nowadays ecosystem is utilized a lot, but if you make these high resolution speakers, transducers, you become very well aware of anything you put in front of it is as relevant as the capacity of the driver. The weakest link of the chain is of course the most important part, because that determines the actual strength of the chain. All the Alcon systems are always driven by the ALC, the amplified loudspeaker controller. More than 20 years ago, we designed this name because we thought that the function of that unit was a lot more controlling than it was amplification. So instead of a controller amplifier, we call it amplified loudspeaker controller. The ALC is taking care of the drive, so both in terms of amplification as well as the processing. So you select a factory preset for this particular model, and then everything is set correctly in terms of filtering, and it's all protected and it's all optimized. So it's just a sort of plug and play approach. In this case with MR10, we have passive mid and high filtering, and then between the mid and the lows is active. So it's a bi-amp system. There is also the option to order the MR10 in a tri-amp configuration. So then everything is taken care of by amplified loudspeaker controller. In this particular case, we utilize the Director 6, which is our latest 8-channel, 8-in, 8-out amplified loudspeaker controller platform. Very high resolution, a new generation of Class D. I would say the performance is quite spectacular. That's a fixed installation 8-channel amp that's specifically designed for immersive applications where you need multi-channel and you still want to be cost-effective in terms of the price per channel.
Experiencing the Alcons MR10 at Gearfest was truly remarkable. The clarity, headroom, and ultra-low distortion of the ProRibbon technology really set them apart from the competition. It's exciting to see these innovations finding their way beyond cinemas and studios. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This is it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Goodbye.